Hello my dear students, welcome back to the video lesson. I am Shweta Gupta, your math teacher, and today I am going to revise exercise 16C and D of lesson number 16 of your math book. So let's start with this revision exercise. Children, exercise 16C is about triangles. So let us revise what we have learnt about triangles. A triangle is a closed figure or shape which is formed by three line segments. In the screen you can see the picture, the diagram of the triangle ABC made up or formed by three line segments, right? So the triangle ABC has three sides, AB, BC and CA. So we can say that a triangle has three sides. It has got three angles. The first angle is angle ABC, the second one angle BCA and the third one angle CAB. Or we can simply say angle B, angle C and angle A. A triangle has three vertices, right? Vertices is the plural of vertex. So what are the vertices in this triangle which is shown in the figure? Well, it is vertex A, vertex B and vertex C. The symbol for triangle is this. This triangle ABC can also be called triangle BCA, triangle CAB, triangle BAC, triangle ACB or triangle CBA. Now children, after revising what is a triangle, let's straight away come to the exercise 16C and do some of the questions as your revision. The first one is question number 2 of exercise 16C. Look at the figure and fill in the blanks. So in the figure you can see there is a triangle, triangle DEF. So the triangle can be symbolically written symbolically as dash. So what will you fill in this blank? Well, triangle DEF. The sides of the triangle are dash. So what are the sides? Well, DE, EF and FD. The vertices of the triangle are D, E, F. The angles of the triangles are angle DEF, angle EFD and angle FDE. Now children, let's come to question number 3. How many triangles are there in figure? Write their names in your notebook. So children, you can see this figure and then you have to find out how many triangles are there in this figure. Well, there are so many triangles. Let us see. The total number of triangles in this figure is equal to 12. And what are these triangles? Let us see. Triangle PMN, triangle MON, triangle PQN, triangle PMR, triangle Q, O, M, triangle Q, N, M, triangle Q, R, N, triangle Q, R, M, triangle Q, O, R, triangle R, M, N, triangle R, O, N, triangle P, Q, R. Now children, the next question is question number 4. Write scalene triangle, equilateral triangle or isosceles triangle. Before moving to this question, let me revise what do we mean by these three types of triangles. You know, triangles are of three types. The first one is equilateral triangle. An equilateral triangle is a triangle in which all the sides are equal. Second one is isosceles triangle. An isosceles triangle is a triangle in which two sides are equal. And the third one is scalene triangle. And in a scalene triangle, none of the two sides are equal, that is, all the sides are different. So now let's move to the question. Can you see the first figure? In this figure, there is a triangle whose two sides are equal to 6 cm and one side is equal to 4 cm. So in this triangle ABC, the two sides are equal. So what type of triangle is this? Well, it is isosceles triangle. An isosceles triangle is a triangle whose two sides are equal. Now let's move to the next figure. In this figure, all the angles are equal to 60 degrees. Means the all the angles of the triangle are equal to 60 degrees. Children, when all the angles of a triangle are equal, its all sides are also equal. Or we can say that this triangle is an equilateral triangle, because only in an equilateral triangle, all the angles are equal and they are equal to 60 degrees. In the third figure, children, there is a triangle RST, and in this triangle, all the sides are different. Means one side is equal to 7 cm, the next side is equal to 6 cm, and the third side is equal to 5 cm. So all the sides are equal. So what kind of triangle is this? Well, this is a scalene triangle where no two sides are equal, or we can say that all the sides are different. So now children, let's come to the fifth question of this exercise. Write acute angle triangle, obtuse angle triangle, or right angle triangle. The first figure is of a triangle, which is triangle ABC, and here one angle A is equal to 50 degrees, angle B is equal to 70 degrees, and angle C is equal to 60 degrees. Children, in this triangle ABC, all the angles are less than 90 degrees, means all the angles are acute angles, right? And a triangle in which all the angles are acute angles, that triangle is called acute angle triangle. So we will write in the box as acute angle triangle. Now let's come to the next figure. In this figure, you can see there is a triangle, triangle HIJ, where angle H is equal to 60 degrees, angle I is equal to 90 degrees, and angle J is equal to 30 degrees. So now in this triangle, one angle is equal to right angle, which is 90 degrees, and the rest of the two angles are less than 90 degrees, means the rest of the two angles are acute angle. So such a triangle in which one angle is equal to 90 degrees and the rest of the two angles are acute angle, such type of triangle is called right angle triangle. So we will write right angle triangle in the box. Now let's move to the third figure. In this, you can see there is a triangle XYZ, and here angle X is equal to 27 degrees, angle Y is equal to 120 degrees, and angle Z is equal to 33 degrees. Children, angle Y is equal to 120 degrees, which is more than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees. So this is an obtuse angle, and rest of the two angles are less than 90 degrees, means they are acute angles. So such a triangle in which one angle is an obtuse angle and rest of the two angles are acute angles, such triangle is called obtuse angle triangle. So we will write obtuse angle triangle. Now children, after revising what is a triangle, let's move to quadrilateral. So let us revise what is a quadrilateral. A quadrilateral is a closed figure made by four line segments. It has four sides, four vertices, four angles, and two diagonals. A quadrilateral is named by its vertices written in order. The line segment joining the opposite vertices of the quadrilateral are called diagonals. Now children, after revising what is a quadrilateral, let's move to exercise 16B and see the second question of this exercise. Look at the figure and fill in the blanks. Children, in this figure you can see there is a quadrilateral A, B, C, D, and this quadrilateral has four sides, side AB, side BC, side CD, and side DA, and This quadrilateral has four vertices, vertex A, vertex B, vertex C, vertex D. And then this quadrilateral has two diagonals. Two diagonals means the line segments that join the opposite vertices. So here the one diagonal is diagonal AC. It is joining the vertex A and vertex C. And the other diagonal is diagonal BD. It is joining the vertex B and vertex D. So now let's answer the following questions. The first question is, the figure ABCD is called a, well, it is called a quadrilateral. The second question, its sides are AB, BC, CD and DA. Third question, its vertices are vertex A, vertex B, vertex C and vertex D. Its diagonals are diagonal BD and diagonal AC. The triangles in the figure are, can you name the triangles which are inside this quadrilateral? Well, they are triangle ABD, triangle CBD, triangle ADC, triangle ABC, triangle OAB, triangle OBC, triangle OCD and triangle ODA. Now children, let's move to the next question. Each angle of the given quadrilaterals is a right angle. Pick the rectangles and squares. Well, let's see the first quadrilateral. In this quadrilateral, see, the two sides are equal to 5 cm and they are the opposite sides, and the other two opposite sides are equal to 4 cm. So children, this is a quadrilateral, a special type of quadrilateral in which all the angles are equal to 90 degrees, and or they are right angle, and the opposite sides are equal, and such type of quadrilateral is called a rectangle. Clear? Now let's move to the next figure, second figure. So in B part you can see there is a rectangle in which all the opposite sides, not opposite side but all the sides are equal. So children, such a rectangle in which all the sides are equal, that rectangle, that is a special type of rectangle which we call square. So this is a square. Now children, let's move to the C part. In C part also you can see that this is a quadrilateral, or we can say this is a special type of rectangle in which all the sides are equal, which are equal to 3 cm. So this is a square. Now let's move to the D part. In D part children, again you can see that this is a quadrilateral in which all the angles are equal to right angle, and the opposite sides of this quadrilateral are equal. Two opposite sides are equal to 2 cm, and the rest of the two opposite sides are equal to 4 cm. So this kind of quadrilateral is a rectangle. So children, this is the home assignment of exercise 16C. And you are going to do these two questions in your notebook as your revision test on your own in a very neat and clean handwriting. Children, this is the home assignment of exercise 16D. You have to do these two questions in your notebook as a revision test, and you are not going to cheat, but you will do these two questions on your own in a very neat and clean handwriting. This way, we have come to the end of this video lesson. Thank you, my dear students. Keep watching, keep learning.